Beloved friends, what should be our proper response to God's marvelous mercies? Now, what would you classify as God's marvelous mercies? I would classify God's marvelous mercy as coming to the earth in the form of Jesus, limiting himself to a flesh and blood and bone body, putting aside his divine nature, coming to the earth, born into the earth just like you and I. However, having an assignment on his life to reveal the Father to us, but to also go to the cross and pay for our sins. When we understand, even as I started out today, what it cost Jesus to bring us to the place of being in relationship with God, that is God's marvelous mercy. So Paul's saying, when you're aware of these things, what should our response be? Because every time God reveals something to us, every time God challenges us, every time we receive light into the Word of God, there needs to be a response, yes or no? So he's saying, well, how should we respond to this? Do we just keep go on living the way we're living, oblivious to the fact that Christ suffered and died, shed his blood on the earth, so that we could come into this relationship with him? He goes on to say, I encourage you to surrender yourselves to God, to be his sacred living sacrifices. God wants living sacrifices. God does not want dead sacrifices. God doesn't want us to get into this habit of coming to church or however you're interacting with God and just say, okay, listen, as long as I pay my tithe, as long as I give big offerings, that should be enough. No, it's not enough. God doesn't need your money. God could do anything he wants with anything on this earth. Jesus fed 15,000 people with a couple of fish and a few loaves of bread. He wants our heart. He wants our inner being. He wants us connected to him, committed to him, consecrated to him, so that he can then live through us. He's not looking for slaves. He's looking for children. He's looking for sons and daughters that have an appreciation for him. Amen?